السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. How are you doing my dear student prep 2? Today we are going to explain unit 2 force and motion. We have three lessons. Lesson 1 fundamental forces in nature. Lesson 2 accompanied forces to motion. Lesson 3 motion. Let's to start first with lesson 1. Fundamental forces in nature. To know the meaning of force, we have many examples. Example number 1, the book on the table remains static as long as no one moves it. Why? Because there is no force acting on it. مفيش force بتأثر عليه. تمام. The second example, the wall doesn't move when you push it with your hands. Why the wall doesn't move? Because the force acting on the object is improper. الفورس مش proper أو مش مناسبة للأوبجيكت اللي عندي. تمام. Three, the static ball moves when you kick it with your foot and stops when the goalkeeper catches it. Why? Because the object state, it changes from static state to motion state or vice versa when a proper force acts on it. بنأثر على movement object to move, it can move. And when the ball changes its direction when the player delivers it with his head. Why? Because the direction of acting force is in the opposite direction of the movement of the object. تمام؟ يبقى الأوبجيكت يقدر يغير الدايركشن بتاعه لما الفورس بتاعتي بتكون in the opposite direction of its movement. طيب من الاكزامبلز دي نقدر نطلع الديفينيشن اوف فورس. So force it is the effect that tries to change the object state from being static to motion or vice versa or tries to change the direction of motion. Again, it is an effect that tries to change the object state from being static to motion or from motion to static or tries to change the direction of motion. And the measuring unit of force is Newton. تمام؟ احنا عارفين ان any physical quantity have its measuring unit. And the measuring unit of force is Newton. Question here, what happens when a proper force acts on number one, a static object. لما يبقى عندي في force بتأثر على static object ايه اللي هيحصل؟ The object will move from its position to another position in the same direction of the force acting on it. تمام؟ طيب ايه اللي هيحصل لما يبقى عندي proper force act on moving object in the same direction of its movement في نفس ال direction. The speed of the moving object will increase. سرعته هتزيد. تمام. بالنسبة لل fundamental forces in nature, we have many different types of forces. These forces cannot be seen in nature, but we can feel them. Like what? Like lightning and thunder, wind motion, gravitational of object to earth, and the attraction of iron to magnets. We cannot see it. And there are forces causing technological application. في forces عندها أو بتسبب technological application. Like what? Generating the electric current, fire weapons, nuclear explosions, and the nuclear reactors. برغم إن the forces differs from each other, but scientists classified them into three types. What are these types? Number one, gravitational forces. Number two, electromagnetic forces. Number three, nuclear forces. which is classified into weak nuclear forces and strong nuclear forces. طيب يلا نبتدي مع بعض بال first force, gravitational force. You know that scientist Newton was the first one who discovered the Earth's gravitational force. أول scientist اكتشف gravitational force. امتى؟ When he was standing under the tree and he found an apple falling down to the ground. لما في one apple falls to the ground, he proved that all masses are attracted towards the Earth itself by a force known as Earth's gravitational force. تمام؟ هو اكتشف ان احنا عندنا Earth's gravitational force. And this force depends on the mass of the object. So, by increasing the mass of the object, the gravity of the Earth towards this object increases. For example, look at this picture. Have a set of objects that differ in mass. For example, say 1 kilogram, 5 kilogram, 10 kilogram, and put them on the ground. Try to lift each mass and to put them on the table, beginning with the smallest mass, then the next in order. هنشيل واحدة واحدة أو نرفعها من الأرض على التابل. A conclusion عندي in our observation, the exerted work to lift objects increase by increasing the object's mass. And an object's mass increases the work done to lift the object upwards increases in the opposite direction of the Earth's gravitational. So the Earth attracts the object to its center by a force called, هنسميها ايه؟ object weight. هنسميها object weight. So the object weight, it's the ability to attract the objects, and it can be measured in Newton. The Earth's ability or ability to, of Earth to attract objects, and it can be measured in Newton. يبقى what is the measuring unit of weight? Newton. We have learned before in grade 6 that weight equal mass times gravitational force. So the product of an object mass multiplied by Earth's gravitational force or gravitational acceleration is weight. W equal m multiplied by g. M represented the mass and G represented the gravitational acceleration and W represented the weight of the object. And we have note here that the weight of an object can be, it changes from place to another on the Earth's surface where its mass remains constant. الماس بتظل ثابتة. ليه؟ Everyone, because the mass is the amount of matter in an object, and this doesn't change by changing place. يبقى انا عندي ال weight of an object, it changes by changing place. Why? According to the gravitational acceleration. So the gravitational acceleration of Earth, it changes according to what? Gravitational acceleration بتتغير according to A. Number one, approach or move away from the center of the Earth. And Earth's gravitational acceleration decreases with L by moving away from the Earth's center. And increases by approaching to the Earth's center. كل ما بقرب من الـ Earth center gravitational force or gravitational acceleration بتزيد معايا. تمام. طيب factor number two, the transfer from one place to another on the Earth's surface. Due to the difference of distance between Earth's surface and its center from one place to another. طب ده معناه ان احنا عندي ان الـ Earth is not complete circle. And the distance between the center of the Earth and any point at two poles is less than the distance between the center of the Earth and any point at equator. Give reason for the weight of the object at the south pole is greater than its weight at the equator. ليه؟ ايه السبب؟ Because the Earth's gravitation acceleration at the south pole is greater than the Earth's gravitation acceleration at equator. كده احنا خلصنا الفورس نمبر 1 اللي هي gravitational force. The second force is electromagnetic force. To know about electromagnetic force, we have experiments, materials, long isolated copper wire, wrought iron bar, and dry battery, iron filings, and open-ended plastic tube, coil the wire in a spiral shape around the plastic tube. هنلف السلك كده على البلاستيك تيوب. Insert the iron bar in the tube. Connect the two ends of the battery of the wire to battery. Approach the iron bar to the iron fittings. What would happen? The iron bar attracted the iron fittings and became a magnet. So the electric current has a magnetic effect. And the iron bar acts as a magnet when the electric current passes through the wire. يبقى الايرن بار ده بيتحول لماجنت لما بوصل التو وايرز to the battery. So what is the application of electromagnetic force? Number one, electromagnet. Its structure, it made up of an isolated, insulated copper wire coiling around the bar of wrought iron. لسه قايلينه من شوية. تمام. And it can be used in making many devices such as electric winches, which lift iron and cars in vortices. And it can be used also in electric bells. بستخدمه في electric bells والelectric winches. دايما السؤال ده بيجي لي complete. The second application is electric generator. Electric generator or dynamo, it converts the mechanical kinetic energy into an electric energy. Like what? The dynamo in a bike. Okay? So, the produced energy is electric energy. The third application is electric motors, which convert the electric energy into mechanical energy. ركز في ان هما الاثنين عكس بعض. Electric motor convert electric energy into mechanical energy. Like what? The motor in a fan and blender or a mixer. كده احنا خلصنا الالكترومغنيتيك فورس. The third force is nuclear force. Scientists have discovered that the atom stores a massive amount of energy. طيب فين الانرجي؟ موجوده in the nucleus. And this massive energy is accompanied by forces known as nuclear force. طيب هنقسم nuclear force دي لايه؟ ل weak nuclear force و strong nuclear force. Weak nuclear force can be used to get radioactive elements and radiations which are used in medicine. Scientists can be used it in researches and industry. تمام؟ يبقى ال uses بتاعت ال weak nuclear force in medicine, scientific researches and in industry. But strong nuclear forces can be used in producing electric energy and in military purpose. تمام؟ دايما الأسئلة بيجي لي هنا على the uses of the weak and strong nuclear forces.